One of the crucial MODX plugins is Wayfinder. It helps you build menus on your website. Let's install it right now. There you go, it's actually under most popular. So let's click Wayfinder, download, back to package management, install. There you go. It helps you build menus, submenus, vertical menus. Just if you need menus, you need Wayfinder, unless your whole website is just a picture of a business card. I will go in more details how it works in the next video, since it's very technical. Now, the next one I use in every project is collections. What collections does is basically collect a series of pages that have a parent. So for example, if you have a blog or a portfolio and you want to list your blog posts, you would create a new document called blog, and then you set it as a collection, and then the children will be blog posts. Or if you have a portfolio, then you have a portfolio page and the children will be portfolio items, like for example I have on my website. Let's install collections. There we go. I like how easy it is to install plugins on MODX. And what I love about MODX is not once have my website crashed because of a new plugin. With WordPress, every time I have to install a new plugin, I am very much afraid the whole website's gonna crash. All right, let's go to package browser, package management, install. Continue. All right, and we have collections. Now let me demonstrate how collections actually work. Let's create a new document, call it a blog, and in settings, let's have it as a resource type of collection, okay? And then let's click save, and there we go. See how the home page is a static page with this icon, and the blog has the three lines, which means that the blog is now a collection. If you click on the blog, you see create child, book actions, search, filter, and the cool thing about collections is you can customize all that, but that will be in a separate video. And if you click on home, which is a static document, you will see that it has your typical page title, long title, content, things like that. And now if we click on blog and click create child, which is funny, but you can actually change the name of the buttons, and let's call it blog post one published, and then this is cool content. Let's save, and voila, we have a blog post, and it's hiding under blog, which makes your website so much more organized. And then you can fetch all those children via GetResources plugin, which reminds me is the next plugin we have to install. And see, you have published, resource title, and all that can be customized. It's very cool. Now let's go back to the installer and download GetResources. Now GetResources, what it does is it fetches resources. For example, I use it a lot with collections, or if I need to display a part of another page into a different page. For example, if I want to display the description of the about page in the footer of the website, then I use GetResources. So I only fetch the description and then I put it in the footer. Now, how it works is quite technical, so we'll cover this in a different video, but it's a really cool plugin. And the funny thing is, oftentimes I would install collections, but I'll forget to install GetResources, and then I would try to fetch collections and they wouldn't display. And then I'll remember that I haven't actually installed this plugin. Okay, so now we have collections, FormIt. FormIt is another vital plugin. It's used to create forms. Although if you have more than three forms, I would suggest you buy Formalicious rather than use FormIt, since Formalicious is better structured. But FormIt is a great plugin for forms. It has built-in honeypot you can use, validation oversight, input validation. It's very cool. And you can also write your own snippets. For example, in one of the forms, there was constant spam, and I saw the pattern of the spam was the user, well, user in parentheses, since they were all bots, you would put the first name and the last name with the same string. So I wrote a snippet checking if the first and the last name were the same, and if they were, then the form would be rejected. So it's really cool plugin. Now the next one I absolutely love and I use in every project is called ClientConfig. Now what ClientConfig does is that it allows you to define global variables to be used in every page. Let's install it. Alrighty. Just install package. And this is very cool because if you go here, now let me clear the cache since we installed it. If we go here in configuration and then click admin, then you can add a setting. Oops, yeah, add a group. For example, I make a label called global settings and then global settings for the website. Save and then add setting. For example, phone number, and then this will be, the label will be phone number of the hospital, for example. And then email, you can make it required, field type, value, global settings, sort order, you can customize everything. I'll set it as text. And then if you go to client view, there you go. You can type the number, save it, and then you can include it in every page of the website. It's really cool. And I usually use it a lot for the global settings, email, phone number, address, you know, everything that has to be used more than once. And you might say, yeah, but I can just type them in into the templates. This is true, but this is something like a global variable that you can use all the time. And if you need to change it, you only need to change it once. So it's pretty cool. Those are the plugins I use in every project. They're really useful. And what I like with MODX is you don't need a ton of plugins to have a website going, which really helps security. I also use GetPage if I need pagination. But if I have like a few resources, I know I have a few resources in collection, then I don't use GetPage, but it's also a very useful plugin.